the 6 local governments in this city, down from Gwagwalada, what's the other part after Gwagwalada? Abaji, going round there, down near Karu, you turn, and by evening you are around angry and exhausted. And God says, rest quickly, in the morning you are starting again. But while that was happening, they did not know what was happening in the eyes. Siba, the way spiritual things work, 5 minutes to their manifestation, it will still look like defeat. Whereas you have finished, you have, they scattered Jericho from the realm of the spirit. The shout was just a system to sink that building down. Consistency. So every day while you are praying, you hold hands with your wife. It's like a register you are signing. Next week, many of us today love God because of our mother's prayers and fasting. For 20 years, they did the same thing. Some of them even had the same position where they knelt and they prayed. They prayed that God will find you. And one day in your rebellion, you just loitered around a crusade and stood there just to check for 5 minutes looking for your friend. And fire from heaven fell upon you there, because everyone that asketh receiveth. Can I tell you this? Satan is the master of the flesh realm, the sense realm, and so he can make you believe that the investments of prayer you are making is not bringing any result. The Bible says the word is quick and powerful. I've been praying over this issue for 1 month. Just when you are 2 days left for victory, you retreat. You know your answer is almost there when the frustration becomes highest. It's an agitation from hell. It's one of the ways you know seasons are about to open. There is a heightened level of frustration. Everybody's annoying you. Your husband annoying you, your wife annoying you, everything annoying you. When that happens, keep at it. It's a sign to frustrate your consistency. Believe me, I know what I'm saying. Father, build your church. Bring revival upon this city. Church history is full of men and women who seem powerless, but they prayed. Men like John Knox, who used prayer to overturn Scotland. Most of the evangelists who had gone to be with the Lord now, before they would go for a crusade in any city, there would be at least 3 months of fire from intercessors. They had a band of intercessors who would pray. They would usually carry the map of the city where they are going to and drop it on their prayer altar. And they are praying everywhere. The powers that hold the destinies of people, the powers from the second heavens, when they finish that, their equipments can now go before them. And it's not the day they stand on that crusade ground that the sick are healed. They finished it since. They only came to manifest. Woe betides a man who uses the stage for rehearsal. The stage is not the place for rehearsal. Whenever God wants to build you, he will take you behind the stage, and that's where you make the prayer investments. You don't stand on stage and that's when you are trying to learn about anointing and power. You are joking. Go and do your homework. When you come out, then you are ready for action. There are gates, hear me, that refuse to open for your father. He knocked it all through his lifetime. It did not open. Refuse to open for your mother. And they all step back. Now God is raising you. Let me tell you what to do. I know what you do. Do what they did not do. They prayed only for 2 weeks and gave thanks and went back. But for you, hold on to the horns of that gate and say, I have come with grace from heaven. Zino kaparus kata brandegede balakata. Rekotoskijabata. What is this pattern of barrenness in this family that will not leave? What is this? Marriages don't seem to work. Everybody returns back to their father's house, minus me. And not only me, I'm not just here to open this gate. I'm here to scatter it so that anybody, see, If it opens for you, they can close it again. But when you scatter the gates, everybody behind you can pass. Can I tell you this? It was Bishop David Oyedepo who said, no matter how mad a man is, he will not enter fire by mistake. He can be mad enough to misbehave, but set fire and there will be a level of decorum and behavior. He makes his angels wings and his ministers flames. One thing I know about fire is that there is no metal it cannot melt. No, if fire refines gold, what else? Exert fire upon that gate. Exert fire upon that altar. And watch what I'm telling you. Believers don't pray. We lament. We close the door and roam around. But we do not engage with the spirit. You are not praying blindly. There are forces that stop helpers from coming to your life. There are forces just when they're about to sign something that becomes an open door. These forces use men and systems and structures. Lift up your head, OE gate. It's not just a pronouncement. There is an activity that you must engage in. Prayers was made by the church for Peter. Prayers was made by the church over the areas of your life. There are areas that if you sit down and allow the devil to keep oppressing you, let me tell you this, Satan is a determined person. He would destroy anything you allow him to destroy. When it was time for the nation of Israel to leave, they said, we will allow you go, but keep your wives behind and keep your children. Moses said, I didn't hear you well. Everybody and everything. I'm not going to live with my health and leave my finances behind. Everything. I'm not going to live with my character and leave my influence behind. Everything must move forward. Hear me, brothers and sisters. By the grace of God and by the privilege of God's mercy, I am a testament of what prayer can do. No, until you take your prayer life seriously, you will teach cheap victories in the spirit. You will shift systems and structures and align men and things to line up purposes of God. Awake, thou that sleepest. This spiritual slumber and laziness is why gates continue to look as though they are strong. This morning, for a few minutes, I want us together as a coordinated army to scatter some gates in this place. Gates of delay, paruske deba lakuzia na haskada, gates of shame and influence. Look at me, please listen. Just help those under the anointing. Listen, there are people who are victims of these prisons that Peter was in. It is the women that feed the men where you come from. No matter how responsible they are, they go to America for 10 years and return back like they've never left their village. What of those who rise just when they get to the place where they should sit down? They come down in shame. They never come down normally. Don't say it does not matter. The one person that becomes the breadwinner. I remember one time something happened to a dear woman, her only son, responsible gentleman. He finished with first class. He was returning back home and he had a ghastly motor accident, died in that instance. Don't tell me that is the will of God. I hope you know these gates we talk about, they are mobile. They are not just in one place. They look for wherever you are and come and stand in front of you. I want to help you. where are you from? You look like you are my relative. Yes, sir. Meet me at the office tomorrow. And those gates come and stand. By the next day, you go to the office. You say, I can't remember. Where did I meet you? And you are wondering, what is going on? Some of you have been in this city for more than one decade. And yet, the gates in the city have refused to open for you. Anything you do fails. You do business, it fails. You have been trying to build. You are still at the foundation level. When you were trying to build, the entire land around you was empty. Till today, you have not lifted it to lintel level. Help them, please. Just help those under the anointing. Listen, I know this by the Spirit. Please give me volume, Elijah. We are going to pray. This is a conference. We will take out time. The Bible says he has broken the gates of brass and cut the bars of iron in sunder. While you are praying, don't pray for yourself alone. Think of your children, born or unborn. Lord, let me pass through this once and for all, so that everybody behind will not have to go through that shame. In 1 minute, I'd like you to open your mouth and begin to pray in the Spirit. Please pray. Pray, walk around, pray, be serious, pray. Shelekete bakata barakatos, entelentes kabaratos kotopreka dekatos yata. Shanakata benda katabarakatos, ekete bakata katopakato kotopreka teketa, shalamente bakato brondo kosko barikata. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. Are you ready to pray? Father, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I decree and declare.
Decree and declare.
By the blood of the eternal covenant.
By the blood of the eternal covenant.
Every gate.
Every gate.
Standing my way.
Standing my way.
Standing in front of my path.
Standing in front of my path.
I clear you by the blood of the Lamb.
Lift your
voice and begin to pray.
In the name of Jesus.
Every gate.
We clear you. We clear you.
Every gate. Every gate. Gates of oppression. Gates of oppression. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Please, if you can, pair yourselves into two. You're married, find your wife or find your husband or find anybody close to you. You are going to pray. Every gate standing in front of our home, it doesn't matter how long, by the blood of the eternal covenant, we command those gates be destroyed. Lift your voice and pray. We decree and declare. In the name of Jesus, every gate, are you praying? Every gate, pray for the person who stands your home. Every gate as men, gate as obstacles, is cut by the power of the Holy Ghost.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.